Just come here quick, Gav.
Yeah.
Gav.
Oh, so Gav. I thought you were calling
Gav,
me.
Stand
okay, we're supposed to be coming with you to interview, yeah? Yeah. We're supposed to be coming. We're supposed to be interviewing you for the promotion. Floyd, I'm supposed to.
No, they're going to do it in Dubai.
Am I supposed to be doing this short interview with Floyd? Floyd. Floyd, could you give me 2 minutes? Will you give me two minutes? How big is it to be able to influence the next generation by doing exhibitions?
If you guys don't know, I'm basically the pioneer of exhibitions. I've started this. This is something that I started, and I also started both, you know, because it's a combat sport. So I was able to mix a boxer with an MMA fighter and mix that also. And I also, you know, as far as just doing exhibitions, traveling all around the world doing exhibitions. So I feel I'm the pioneer of doing it.
I think you were doing it the last 10 years of your boxing career, by the way.
A little bit.
Onwards, you were kind of doing exhibitions.
Well,
there's no one. Listen, I've covered you for 25 years.
Thank you.
No one with those skills on earth.
Well, you know, I'm truly, truly blessed. And, you know, I can never overlook anyone. I want to say thank you to all the fans from around the world that have supported me. I wouldn't be where I'm at without the fans. And so many people work this behind the scenes, like this man right here, James McNair.
Yeah, he's always there.
You know, on social media, you can follow him, the Harlem Hot Boy. You know, he worked extremely hard every day and every night, you know, up 20 hours, you know, working on events for me. So these are a lot of people that's behind the scenes, you know, my security, Ron, Josh, you got Ken right here. You got Badu. You got so many people that works, you know, Mike, my team.
You're giving out a
hard.
Lot of wisdom now, though, as well, up on that stage tonight.
It's just that I'm older and wiser. So, you know, yeah. I've been here, you know, when you've been in the sport, but
in the public eye as well, all the time, all those things.
Well, you know, everybody's entitled to feel how they want to feel about me. You know, I know I've been a good person. You know, I'm blessed way beyond belief. And it's okay to, you know, congratulate these fighters and push these fighters to be great. You know, I had a great career, and hopefully we're looking for the next we're not just looking for the next Floyd Mayweather. We're looking for the next to surpass Floyd Mayweather. At least I am.
Who is going to be that then?
We don't know. We just never know.
When you are getting older and wiser,
because you know, we never thought that we would. Of course, you'll never see another Floyd Mayweather. You'll never see another Muhammad Ali. And the list, you'll never see another Mike Tyson. You'll never see another Sugar Ray Leonard. So, and the list goes on and on. It's certain fighters that just very, very special, you know? And when they gave me the chance, you know, to take things to the next level, that's what I did.
And are you serious about coming here in February? Because we'd love to see you in the UK in a big stadium, Wembley Stadium.
I've been talking with Ken. Hopefully we're able to come over here and make it happen. You know, in due time, we just don't know.
You'll never give it up, will you?
I don't have to fight. I don't have to fight.
Yeah, but you still love it.
No.
You don't love it anymore.
No. It's a quick pick. Quick pick up, have something to do. And keep me in shape.
Thanks, brother. Always great to see you. Thank you so much. Cheers, Floyd.